أحييكم أحييكم وبالأشواق ناتيكم فأغلى وردنا أنتم وكل ورد نوتيكم
أحييكم أحييكم وبالأشواق ناتيكم فأغلى وردنا أنتم وكل الورد نوديكم أحييكم وبالأشواق ناتيكم فأغلى وردنا أنتم وكل الورد نوديكم
عصافير من الخلد تغرد بين آليكم جوانحنا لكم سرر ومن دمنا نخاديكم عصافير من الخلد تغرد بين آليكم جوانحنا لكم سرر ومن دمنا نخاديكم جوانحنا لكم سرر ومن دمنا نخاديكم
أحييكم أحييكم وبالأشواق ناتيكم فأغلى وردنا أنتم وكل الورد نوديكم
ألا ما أجمل اللقيا وما أحلى تلاقيكم بكم ضاءت محافلنا وعم النور ناتيكم ألا ما أجمل اللقيا وما أحلى تلاقيكم بكم ضاءت محافلنا وعم النور ناتيكم
أحييكم أحييكم وبالأشواق ناتيكم فغلى وردنا أنتم وكل الورد نوديكم
فيا أهلا ويا مرحى حللتم بين أهليكم بكأس الحب نترعة وصافي الود ناسقيكم فيا أهلا ويا مرحى حللتم بين أهليكم بكأس الحب نترعة وصافي الود ناسقيكم فيا أهلا ويا بكأس الحب نترعة وصافي الود ناسقيكم
أحييكم أحييكم
قلوب الناس أجناد كما قد قال ناتيكم فإن ألفت فقد عرفت شمائل قد بدات فيكم قلوب الناس أجناد كما قد قال ناتيكم فإن ألفت فقد عرفت شمائل قد بدات فيكم
أحييكم أحييكم وبالأشواق ناتيكم فأغلى وردنا أنتم وكل الورد نوديكم
وعن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال أخذ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بمنكبي فقال كن في الدنيا كأنك غريب أو عابر سبيل وكان ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما يقول إذا أمسيت فلا تنتظر الصباح وإذا أصبحت فلا تنتظر المساء وخذ من صحتك لمرضك ومن حياتك لموتك Narrated Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنهما The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took hold of my shoulders and said, Be in the world as if you were a stranger or a wayfarer. Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma used to say, When you survive till the evening, do not expect to be alive till the morning. And when you survive till the morning, do not expect to be alive till the evening. Do good deeds when you are in good health before you fall sick. And do good deeds as long as you're alive before death strikes.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Ladies and gentlemen, when I first came to this school on my first day, I mistakenly thought that I would expect the worst, but I was wrong. Today I would like to share with you something extraordinary about our school. Thank you. First and foremost, let's talk about the beautiful greenery that surrounds our school. Just take a moment to appreciate the lush green gardens, the well-maintained lawns, the vibrant flowers that add life and color to our surroundings. These green spaces not only enhance the aesthetics of our campus, but also provide a serene and peaceful environment for learning and relaxation. Secondly, let's explore the classrooms. Our school is equipped with well-maintained, comfortable classrooms that serve as the foundation of our learning journey, where knowledge is shared, discussions take place, and ideas are born. They provide a conducive environment for us to engage with our teachers and peers. Fostering an atmosphere of collaboration and intellectual growth. Furthermore, I want to highlight the Islamic attributes of our school. As an Islamic school, we place a strong emphasis on nurturing our Islamic identity and values. Our infrastructure reflects this commitment with a mosque right within our premises. This place of worship not only caters to the spiritual needs of our students, but also serves as a symbol of unity and devotion within our diverse community. In addition to our Islamic focus, our school also follows the Cambridge curriculum, offering a well-rounded education that prepares us for academic excellence and personal growth. This combination of both Islamic and Cambridge curricula provides us with a unique and enriching educational experience, blending the best of religious teachings and international standards. Now let's talk tech. Our school is equipped with a state-of-the-art ICT lab, complete with Mac laptops. Imagine the endless possibilities that open up when we have access to such advanced technology, from programming to graphic design, from research to creativity. This lab empowers us to explore and learn and create in the digital world. When it comes to sports and physical well-being, our school doesn't disappoint. We have spacious football and basketball fields where students engage in healthy competition and stay physically active. These fields are not just a place for sports, but also a hub for teamwork. Sportsmanship and camaraderie, ensuring the safety and security of our students, is of utmost importance, and our school takes this responsibility seriously. We have implemented a biometric system and CCTV cameras to ensure the well-being of everyone on campus. These measures provide a sense of security and a peace of mind, allowing us to focus on our studies without any worries. And what about sustenance? Well, we're fortunate to have a cafeteria and a kitchen in our school that is well maintained. Our cafeteria provides nutritious meals that fuel our minds and bodies, while the modern kitchen ensures that hygiene and quality are never compromised, so we can satisfy our hunger and concentrate on our studies without having to worry about lunchtime logistics. Henceforth, the infrastructure of our school is not just a backdrop to our daily activities. It is an integral part of our educational journey, from the beautiful greenery to the classrooms, the mosque to the ICT lab, the sports fields to the biometric system. Our school's infrastructure enriches learning experience, promotes Islamic values, and prepares us for a bright future. Let's cherish and make the most of these amazing facilities as we continue to thrive in our academic pursuits. Thank you, and Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
For so long, and boom, all Do not become depressed to the degree that you start to question Allah. People say, why is Allah testing me? Why? Because he doesn't like me. Well, if that's the case, he didn't like anyone on earth because everyone is tested. Even Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the most loved by Allah, the best of creations and the highest of all, top creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without a doubt, he has been through more tests than you and I. It's the sign of the love of Allah.
For you are the rewards, ready to present a poem entitled Never Stop Learning. Sit back, relax, and enjoy yourself. We watch each other learn and grow and change from day to day. We hope that all the things we've done will help us along the way. On this your graduation day, all stand and give cheer to honor you for all the work you've done to get you here.
In front of you, Zia Qasim, ready to present to you khutbah about the importance of the Quran.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'firuhu wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyati a'malina. Man yahdillahu fala mudilla lah, wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Verily, all praises for Allah. We praise Him, we seek His assistance, and we ask for forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Him from the evils of ourselves. Whoever Allah guides, none can guide. Whoever He misguides, none can guide. And I bear witness that there is no deity other than Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a slave and messenger. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O you who believe, fear Allah as you should be feared, and die not except in a state of Islam. O people, the noble Quran has descriptions that Allah Almighty conveyed through His verses. If people comprehend and reflect on it and act on it, then their hearts would be reciprocified, their conditions would be improved, and they would have the bliss in this world and the next. However, not reciting, understanding, and reflecting on the Quran resulted in many Muslims being denied the blessings, benefit, and guidance of the Quran. Indeed, the most important description of the Quran and the one that appears the most in its verses is that it is guidance that guides mankind as individuals and societies to what suits them in all their affairs. This divine description couples the month of the Quran revelation with this guidance. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. The month of Ramadan is that in what revealed the Quran, a guidance for the people and clear proofs of guidance and criterion. And the guidance of the Quran spans immediate and future interests and achieves the benefits of this world and the hereafter. The Quran enlightens people about the Lord Almighty and guides them to Him and reveals to them His actions, names, and description, and discloses to them what they need to know from the unseen, which propels them to Iman, faith, and righteous deeds. The description of the Quran as guidance has been repeated in many verses. Hudan lil-muttaqin, a guidance for those cautious of Allah. Hudan wa bushra lil-mu'mineen, as guidance and good tidings for the believer. Hudan wa rahmatan lil-muhsineen, as guidance and mercy for the doers of good. Hudan wa dhikra li-ulil-albab, as guidance and a reminder for those of understanding. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت، وعافنا فيمن عافيت، وتولنا فيمن توليت، وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت، وقنا شر ما قضيت، إنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك، وإنه لا يذل من واليت. رب تباركت ربنا وتعالي.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة، أصحاب الجنة هم لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو، عالم الغيب والشهادة، هو الرحمن الرحيم. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام، هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر. سبحان الله عما يشركون. هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور، له الأسماء الحسنى، يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض، وهو العزيز الحكيم. صدق الله العظيم.
تكبير. تكبير. That is, mashallah, great Quran recitation after the khutbah. Now what is remaining is just some biryani and pilau, but Allah knows best.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم صدق الله العظيم
The next item is a welcoming song entitled Jambalaya Welcome
Jambalaya Habari gani Muzuri sana Wageni Habari
Jambo sana, habari gani? ni mazuri sana, wageni wakaribishwa.